Hei alle sammen! Hvordan går det med dere? Går det fint? Bra! Jeg er Emma, og dette er Jan. Hallo, Jan!
Hei, Emma! Hei alle sammen! Det er hyggelig å treffes igjen. Hello there! We only used Norwegian in the introduction. Did you understand? Did you understand almost everything? Or maybe even everything? Great! Veldig bra! Today, we're going to learn to count and try to do shopping in a grocery store. How wonderful!
Hva sier du?
Jeg sier at vi skal telle. I've just told Emma that today we're going to count. Did you understand my phrase? Jeg sier. I tell. At. That. Vi skal telle. Jeg sier at vi skal telle. About shopping. I didn't tell Emma about it, so let's just keep it as a secret for a while. Okay? Have you done your homework from the second lesson? You think that I've already forgotten it? Nei, nei. I didn't forget the homework from the third lesson either. So, if you haven't already learned it, play the earlier lessons quickly and learn. It's really fun to learn with NorwegianABC.com. Let's begin with numbers. La oss begynne. Norwegian currency is krone. Norsk krone. En krone, or ei krone. Masculine or feminine gender.
Norsk krone. En krone. Or ei krone.
One norsk krone consists of 100 øre, but Norway recently changed their currency system, so now the lowest valued coin is 1 krone. The word øre means ear also, but if money øre is en øre of masculine gender, an ear is the noun of neuter gender. Et øre. As you can see, learning the gender of a noun is very important. Veldig viktig. Let's go back to numbers. I'll ask you to count from 1 to 10 in Norwegian. 1. How did you do? I hope you don't lie about doing it. Ok, ok. Let's count together. 1. 2. 3. 4. 5, 6, 7 eller 7, 8, 9, 10. In Norwegian, we can say 7 as 7 or 7. 7 is more commonly used in spoken language, and in formal written language, it is more common to use 7. It doesn't matter which one you like more, we have to learn to pronounce both words correctly. Syv. Syv. Sju. Sju. Emma, can you help us pronounce it?
Ja, jeg kan hjelpe. Syv. Syv. Sju. Sju.
You probably have a question. Why are there three words for the number 1? And when should we use each of them? Oh my, you may think that there's got to be some kind of a complicated grammar rule. I'll make you all happy. Truly not. It's very simple. Remember, we've been talking about noun genders in the first lesson. There are three of them. And each gender is marked by a different article. Do you remember the articles? En, ei, et. They sound just like the number 1, right? So, whichever one, en, ei, or et, we use depends on the gender of a noun. For instance, if we want to say one girl, how do we say that? Think a little longer.
Ei jente. Ei jente.
Ja, riktig. Correct. One girl. Ei jente. Ei, the article to a noun of feminine gender. Ei jente. A noun of feminine gender, so we have combined them perfectly. If we want to say one house, house is et hus. A noun of neuter gender, we say et hus, et hus. And if we talk about one car, en bil, a noun of masculine gender, we say en bil, en bil. Let's continue and learn to count to 20. It's quite simple. Repeat after us. Don't forget to look at it in a fun way. And relax. Elve.
Elve. Elve.
Tol.
Tol. Tol.
Tretten.
Tretten. Tretten.
Fjorten.
Fjorten. Fjorten.
Femten.
Femten. Femten.
Seksten.
Seksten. Seksten.
Sytten.
Sytten. Sytten.
Atten.
Atten. Atten.
Nitten.
Nitten. Nitten.
Tjue or tyve.
Tjue or tyve. Tjue or tyve.
Here it is, that special syllable, sh, which we meet in the number 20. Tjue. Do you remember that we have to pronounce it like a mixture of syllables? Ch and sh. Don't say ch. Don't say sh either. Let's try it together. Sh. 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 Tjue. 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 I'm a little tired. Jeg trøtt. Jeg trøtt.
Du trøtt, Jan? Vel, jeg skal telle. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 og 20. Uff, jeg trøtt også.
Jeg imponert, Emma. I'm amazed. Tusen takk skal du ha. Thank you very much. Jeg skal si det en gang til. I'll repeat it once again. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 or 20. And now I'm going to continue. 20 is 20. 20. By the way, have you noticed that 20 and 7 sound very similar to 20 and 7? So if you say 7 in Norwegian, you should use 7. That's more simple and you won't mix 7 and 20. Now let's try to say 21. In Norwegian, it will be a one compound word. Let's try. 21, 21,
21, 21,
22, 22,
22, 22,
23, 23,
23, 23.
24, 24,
24 24
25 25
25 25
26 26
26 26
27 27 or 27
27 or 27 27 or 27
28 28
28 28
29 29
29 29
Let's repeat one more time. En gang til. 21 21 22 22 23 23 24 24 25 25 26 26 27 27 or 27 28 28 29 29 Emma, now it's your turn to count from 20 to 29. And you, our students, can relax a bit, make some tea or something, and repeat together.
20 21 22 23 24 25 26 27 eller 27 28 29 Did you manage to remember? Går det bra? Everything is fine. Dere veldig flinke. Let's continue. In exactly the same way, saying the 10 and adding a number in Norwegian, we can say 35, 57, but of course, at first we need to learn all the tens, right? Want to try? Let's repeat together. 10 10
10 10
20 20
20 20
30 30
30 30
40 30
40 40
50 50
50 50
60 60
60 60
70 70
70 70
80 80
80 80
90 90
90 90
100 Ett or en hundre
Ett eller en hundre Ett hundre or en hundre
En gang til.
10 10 20 20 30 30 40 40 50 50 60 60 70 70 80 80, 90, 90, 100, 100. Perhaps you think the words 13, 13, and 30, 30, 15, 15, and 50, 50 sounds very similar. Pay attention to the point that when spelling ordinal numbers, that is numbers from 13 to 19, we can hear the ending n. 13, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. And when spelling tens, we will hear the ending ti. That is 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. But maybe learning numbers seems difficult for you. In fact, it is not difficult, but we are learning many of them all at once in this lesson. Remember how you used to learn things in preschool or school? We used to not rush and repeat things many times. In the beginning, we learned to count to 10, then to 20, and later to 100. So, don't hurry and repeat the material of our lesson till you manage all the numbers. With NorwegianABC.com, you can do it everywhere, at any comfortable time and cozy place. Sing the numbers loudly in the shower. Repeat them in your head when running on a treadmill in a gym or along a path in a park. Loudly name them together with us when driving to work in the mornings. Or silently speak nodding in a trolley bus, or maybe sitting comfortably on a couch. What matters is that you should listen to NorwegianABC.com lessons till you learn everything perfectly. Sant, Emma? Isn't that true, Emma?
Yeah. Let's count one more time together from 0 to 10. Vi skal telle sammen. We will count together. Sammen. Together. A warm, sociable word, so let's learn it. And this phrase also. Vi skal telle sammen. Let's begin. La oss begynne. Null. En. To. Tre. Fire. Fem. Seks. Sju. Åtte. Ni. Ti.
Now, from 11 to 20. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Well, and now from 21 to 29. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29.
And now we'll count in tens from 10 to 100. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Uff, veldig bra. Here I'm praising not only you, but myself too. We have done some counting in a fun way. And now let's play. I will say a number and you say it in Norwegian. Remember how tens are made? For instance, 57. We say 50 at first and then 7. 57. Let's begin. Don't worry, you know that I will help you. So I say a number and you say it in Norwegian. Ok? After a short pause, you will hear the correct answer. Don't be tense, you can do it. La oss begynne. 34.
34. 34.
44.
44. 44.
57.
57 or 57.
69
69
78
78 78
83
83
95
95 Veldig bra. Flott. Very good. Great. You see, it's not difficult at all. You have learned to spell 100 words already. And now let's learn another 1,000 words. I'm not forcing you. We're just going to learn to spell numbers till 1,000 in a simple way. 100 is 1 or 100. 200 is 200. 300. 300. Simple, right? You can count from 1 to 9 and 100 will be 100. As simple as a child's game, as my grandmother used to say. So, 400. 400. 500. 500. 600. 600. 700. 700. 800. 800. 900. 900. 1,000. 1,000 or 1,000.
And now this is the last time you will suffer from numbers. Let's learn to spell hundreds. For instance, 252 will be 252. 105, 105. You've already noticed that I say it with the word and, og. Norwegians say it this way. 105, 252. It's important when spelling hundreds and when adding tens or units to them, we always say og. Let's listen to more examples. 303. 303. 670. 670. And now you try. Emma will say a number in Norwegian and you say how it sounds in English. After a pause, I will tell you the answer. Ready? Let's begin.
106.
106.
171.
171.
201.
201.
297.
297.
345.
345. And how did you do? I suspect that the first times might be difficult. Still, if you faithfully listen several times, I'm sure that after some time, you will count as easily as Norwegians. We wish you all good luck. Lykke til! So, that's all about numbers. I think it's enough for today, really. Don't forget to repeat the material of this lesson till you learn to count correctly until 1,000. Well, are you still capable to go shopping with us today? What do you think? It would be fun, wouldn't it? Perhaps we're hungry and thirsty after that numbers business. So let's say I'm hungry. Jeg sulten.
Jeg sulten. Jeg sulten.
I am thirsty. Jeg tørst.
Jeg tørst. Jeg tørst.
I am hungry and thirsty. Jeg sulten og tørst.
Jeg sulten og tørst. Jeg sulten og tørst.
And now let's ask our companion if he's hungry. Er du sulten? Er is a form of the verb å være. Å være. In present tense. Er du sulten? Word by word, are you hungry? According to a rule of Norwegian question making, we put er into the first place, then du, sulten. Er du sulten?
Ja, jeg sulten. Jeg veldig sulten.
Emma is saying that she's very hungry. Veldig sulten. Let's ask if she's thirsty. Er du tørst, Emma? Er du tørst, Emma?
Jeg veldig tørst. Ja, jeg veldig tørst. Jeg lyst til å drikke. Jeg lyst til å drikke.
Ja vel. Well, Emma is very thirsty too. She's just said an unknown phrase. Jeg lyst til å drikke. What words in this phrase do we know already? Jeg is I. Yes, that's right. Lyst til. I want. An infinitive of a saying is spelled together with the infinitive particle å. Å ha lyst til. After this saying, we can use a verb only in its infinitive form, like this. Jeg lyst til å drikke. Å drikke. To drink. If we want to say that we want some kind of a thing or an object, but not to do something, we will say it this way. Jeg lyst på. And then we'll say the noun or what we want. Well, let's say, jeg lyst på bil. I want a car. Jeg lyst på bil. A good wish, right? But we won't buy a car today. We'll go to buy some food. Uko? So then, it would be better to say it this way. Jeg lyst til å drikke og å spise. Å spise. To eat. Og spise. Let's go to the grocery store. So what are we going to buy for a drink? Maybe water? Vann. Water.
Vann. Vann.
Maybe milk? En melk. Milk.
En melk. En melk.
And maybe juice? Juice without sugar? En juice or en juice?
En juice? En juice?
And juice with sugar? Ei saft. En saft.
Ei saft or en saft? Ei saft or en saft?
Or maybe a soda. En brus. Soda.
En brus. En brus.
I know what we should buy to stay awake and capable of learning as much Norwegian as possible. Coffee. En kaffe.
En kaffe. En kaffe.
By the way, when Norwegians say en kaffe, they have in mind not only coffee, but also a cup of coffee. And maybe we can quench our thirst with tea. Tea. En te. En te. Black tea. Svart te.
Svart te. Svart te.
Green tea. Grønn te.
Grønn te. Grønn te.
Jeg liker grønn te. I like green tea. Jeg liker grønn te. But we'll talk about our likes later, And now I'm going to name more drinks. Whereas you, while calmly sipping your favorite one, can listen, repeat, and learn.
Well, maybe we could taste some strong drinks, such as beer, which English people like so much. Beer? Et øl.
Øl. Jeg liker øl. Et øl. Et øl.
Jan seems to like beer, and maybe you are fond of wine. Wine? En vin.
En vin? En vin?
White wine. En hvit vin.
En hvit vin. En hvit vin.
Red wine. En rød vin.
En rød vin. En rød vin. If you want to buy some wine or other strong drinks in Norway, you'll have to go to a specialized shop. Et vinmonopol.
Jan, jeg har lyst til å spise. Jeg veldig sulten. Kan vi avslutte nå?
Did you understand? Emma is saying that she wants to eat. Jeg har lyst til å spise. And she also asked if we can finish now. Kan vi avslutte nå? Well, that's it for today. Maybe it's really time to have a meal. In our next lesson, we will definitely continue shopping and learning a lot of useful phrases. Words in a beautiful and proper Norwegian language. Together with NorwegianABC.com, it's fun to learn. See you next time! Ha det bra! Vi høres!
Ha det bra, alle sammen! Vi høres!